we're talking about this generation, I don't know what this generation is all about.
I don't either.
It's a whole new thing.
Well, they're fragile. They're hothouse plants. Well, they were.
What about misinformed?
They were raised wrong.
What about misinformed? What about not having?
Some of it is not their fault, of course.
What about not having a sense of history?
Right. No, absolutely. You're so right. They do not know anything.
I mean, what would older men who seem to have all the privilege in the world be if they weren't crapping on young people in America, right? So Bill Maher was recently having a discussion with actor Billy Dee Williams on his podcast. If you're unfamiliar with Williams, he's a Star Wars actor. And Maher decided to call young people houseplants. Hey, don't laugh at me, okay? I totally knew that and I didn't have to look it up or be informed about Williams and what he started.
No, she didn't.
No, totally knew. Yeah. Anyway, so they're having a conversation about what seems like increasingly strained relationships between Black and Jewish Americans. And that led to a discussion about how young people are supposedly misinformed. But pay close attention to the examples he uses to make his argument. Take a look.
They do not know anything, but it's not their fault because, you know, it's not the responsibility of the child to instruct themselves. I never had to worry about that. Kids today know nothing. They know you don't have to know anything and they will sign that diploma and kick you out the door if you even finish it. It's criminal. Yes, they don't know anything, but it doesn't sap their confidence in still opining on everything as if they did know something, like about Gaza. Stuff like that.
Listen, Bill Maher doesn't like the fact that young people are more critical of Israel than older people. That young people haven't bought into some of the brainwashing that makes Israel appear to be innocent 100% of the time and Palestinians guilty 100% of the time. And so, yeah, I would actually venture to say that on that particular issue, he actually doesn't like the fact that young people are more informed and can cut through the BS on the propaganda that tends to favor Israel, regardless of what its government carries out.
Yeah, he's conflating two totally different issues. You might be surprised to hear that I kind of agree with him on one of the issues.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, but definitely not both. So what do I mean?
You're getting up there in age. Maybe that's what it is. I'm just kidding.
Okay. So he says young people know nothing. They can get a diploma for, you know, just showing up. Wait, the part about the diploma is unfortunately a little bit true.
It is, yeah, I agree.
And so that's the part I agree with. And that's not because young people suck. It's because we devastated funding for public schools.
No, I disagree. I think what he's referring to colleges, right?
I thought he was referring to high schools, but even if he's referring to colleges, that's a little bit more of a mixed bag. I mean, it's not like people that go to these elite colleges know nothing, but are they, you know, on average way more left wing? Yes, that's true. And that's a third issue. That's a different issue, not knowing nothing.
Well, look, what I took that comment to mean is that honestly, grade inflation is a real thing, and it is a real thing.
Yeah, that's definitely true.
Yeah, so
that's right.
There is truth to people who aren't really prepared to go through their education, essentially passing because their teachers will pass them and they get through it without having the skills necessary to enter the job market and you know, perform well.
Yeah, and there's two different kinds of grade inflation at public schools and in private schools. At public schools, there's grade inflation like, let them pass.
Yeah.
Just go, give them a C, let's get them out of here, right? And then people will come out not knowing how to read or write sometimes, and it's heartbreaking, right? In private schools, just give them an A because the parents complain too much. Okay, that's a different grade inflation.
Mm-hmm.
So those things are true, but then he conflates it with young people know nothing and look at them, they don't even believe Israeli propaganda anymore. Because Bill Maher, he's a complicated dude, he's right about some things, and he's a total zealot on other things. And when it comes to Israel, he's entirely irrational. He's so biased, he can't see straight. There isn't like a right wing zealot in Israel that he wouldn't get behind. And so he's just the worst on that issue. And so no, Bill, just because they didn't believe your stupid Israeli propaganda doesn't mean that they don't know anything. In fact, they know way more than you do. You think, oh golly gee, Israel killed 33,000 people. It was all an accident. Oh, 23,000 women and children. Oh, they were just trying to kill terrorists. You look like an idiot when you say, and totally lack of knowledge, lack of simple basic understanding of the issues. So you two can play at this game, and if you catch feelings, and he does, I know for a fact that he watches some of our stuff and catches feelings and doesn't like it when we criticize him. Okay, but you get to say all sorts of crap about everybody else, but the minute your elitist ass is touched, how dare you? Right. The reality is, on average, the thing that they forget Gaza and specific issues, do young people know more or less? Now, there's no meta study on that, and I can't tell you a scientific answer to it, but in my experience, based on what I've seen, on average, they know a lot more. And why? Because on TV, you get nothing but pulp. You get super generalized conversations, and it's all theater and nonsense about, oh, Lindsey Graham thinks this, and Senator Coons on the Democratic side thinks that. That's garbage. In reality, young people know what old people don't know, because they don't watch TV. They know that it's all the campaign contributions, and they can show you what the money that Raytheon spends, Big Pharma spends, etc. They're much more savvy about what's actually happening in politics, as opposed to the buffoons on television that are still talking as if there's real debates in America.
He also went from criticizing the notion of Biden running for re-election to fully supporting Biden and telling anyone who criticizes his economy or how things are going in America to basically kick rocks. He said, quote, stop acting like life in America in 2024 is unbearable. Biden's ratings are in the toilet, not because he's doing such a bad job, but because a lot of Americans like to live with their head in the toilet. I mean, completely ignoring that inflation continues to be a problem, especially when it comes to the price of food. A lot of Americans are struggling with that. You still have a huge percentage of Americans living paycheck to paycheck, unable to afford a $400 emergency. You also have the issue of the migrant crisis impacting a lot of these Democratic strongholds, these big cities like Chicago, Denver, New York City. I mean, he can go ahead and live the kind of lifestyle that's completely detached from that reality because of his wealth. But to sit there and to tell Americans to just shut up, kick rocks, and support Biden is laughable to say the least. And finally, if we're gonna have a discussion about delicate people, okay, fragile people, about the houseplants, let's talk a little bit about Bill Maher and his ridiculously hurt feelings over not getting invited to a ridiculous party. Sources say the host of HBO's Real Time fired CAA, that's a agency, his reps for more than two decades after he was not invited to CEO Brian Lord's private Oscar party at his home. Maher, according to sources, was furious that he was snubbed for the event.
So I see that he's got real world problems, and right. So my bad, I gotta withdraw my criticism. Now brother, your head is buried in a pile of cash. And so you can't see straight, so you say absurd things like this. Look, Biden, in his mind, improved the status quo by a little bit, and he's thinking, I don't understand why you guys are upset. He doesn't think this consciously, he thinks it subconsciously. He's thinking, I was already mega rich, and then Biden made my life a tiny bit better, so I love Biden. But brother, if you weren't already mega rich, Biden didn't help you that much. We needed a giant change in the status quo,
right?
Because most like 40% of Americans get knocked out by a $400 bill and can't recover and are risking bankruptcy. You think that Biden helped them a lot?
Yeah.
No, he didn't move the needle at all on that, but you can't see straight because everyone you know is multimillionaires and you guys are like, everything's great, right? Everything's great. Oh, these ungrateful masses, how dare they complain about Biden? That's rich, if you will.
And honestly, I feel like the person here who has the hurt feelings is Bill Maher, who can't stand the fact that there are young people who disagree with him on the war on Gaza.
Oh, totally. And
that's what this is really about.
How dare you, insolent kids, not realize that Israel should get $4 billion a year, $14 billion extra, and that genocide's not that big a deal. And of course, if Israel's doing it, it's not a genocide. Yeah. If Hamas had murdered 33,000 Israelis, it would be the worst crime in world history. And by the way, I agree with that. That would be awful and it would be terrorism. 23,000 women and children starving a million Israelis. Imagine if Hamas did that. We would all agree, worst terrorist in the world. But when Israel does it, you young people don't know. They have a special exemption. Bill Maher likes them and he doesn't like the Palestinians. Yeah. So their lives are irrelevant. Why don't young people know that? All right, let's go to a commercial break where I will then slurp more cash right into my body. Okay, hey, but I don't know why I'm out of touch.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.